Today, I'm going to be talking about what your favourite lucid dreaming technique says about you. Now, if it doesn't become painfully obvious right away, this is just a bit of a joke, just a bit of good fun. Without further ado, let's get started. Affirmations. Your favourite book is either Think and Grow Rich or How to Win Friends and Influence People. You probably trade stocks or crypto, and you probably also drive a fairly flashy car. Binaural beats. Your favourite genre of music is 432Hz tones for deep meditation. Use an ad blocker or YouTube Premium, because who needs ads interrupting those multiple hour-long videos when you're trying to sleep? DEILD. Your favourite movie is Inception. You have an embarrassingly empty dream journal, because why write down your dreams when you can just do DEILD and go back and have another one? Eye masks. You just want a good night's sleep. This whole lucid dreaming thing is just a nice benefit. You also might work a night shift or be a night owl and sleep during the day. Filed. You might play piano, and you might also have a collection of synthesizers, and yet still feel like you need just one more. You probably like watching high-production YouTube videos with lots of fancy editing, and you're only watching this one because your usual favourite lucid dreaming YouTuber hasn't uploaded anything today. Galantamine and Huperzine A. You have a cupboard full of supplements, half of which you don't even know what, if anything, they actually do, or if they even work for you, but you still take them anyway, just in case. You play games on easy difficulty or with cheats enabled. Or you're a lucid dreaming YouTuber yourself who has one too many bottles that you've received from supplement companies to test out. Hypnosis and guided meditations. You like lucid dreaming. You really like lucid dreaming. When I count to three, you will like the video. One, two, three. Intention technique. You're either a student or a high-earning CEO. There's no in-between. You watch videos and listen to audiobooks on 2x speed, because who even has the time for that otherwise? Your dream journal entries are one sentence per dream, and you hate alarms with a passion. Lucid dreaming masks. You've personally contributed to at least 4 Kickstarter campaigns, only one of which ever came back with a finished product. Your favourite headphones are LCD2 Classics, and you literally bought them just because of how heavy they are. Mantras. Thanks to people like me who use the term wrong, you probably still call it mild. You own at least one book on mindfulness, and you know you're supposed to set an alarm and wake up in REM first, but most of the time you just recite your mantras before bed at the beginning of the night. Meditation. Yeah, that's all I'm going to say on this one. Just kidding, your life is either a complete mess or really well put together. You work out regularly and you try and eat healthy, and you spent an unhealthy amount of time on Alan Watts lectures. Mild. Your favourite website is PubMed, and you've read every lucid dreaming study. Your middle name is peer-reviewed, and you either have or are working towards a PhD. If you had the opportunity, you would take part in a lucid dreaming study if you haven't already taken part in or organised one. Nap chaining. Your best friend is the snooze button. You set at least 3 alarms every morning, and you usually don't get up until the last one. You have an Apple Watch that monitors your sleep quality, and it always says you don't sleep enough, even when you're in bed for 10 hours. Reality checks. Your phone goes off every 30 minutes. You have reminders and alarms set just to remind you to set more reminders and alarms. You journal and use at least 2 separate productivity or to-do list apps to keep you on track. You either use no other lucid dreaming techniques, or you use so many that it would take you a minute to count them out right now. You also don't mind looking a little weird in public. RILD. You have a habit of rehearsing speeches and interviews either in the shower or in front of the mirror. Wake back to bed. You are one of those inhuman people who can sleep at any time without difficulty. You probably also do nap chaining from time to time. You don't even need alarms at this point because you wake up in REM automatically now. And you have the longest dream journal entries out of anyone on this list because you spend about 15 to 20 minutes writing them every morning during your wake back to bed period. Wild. You've probably tried the most techniques out of anyone on this list, and you finally settled on wild. You either spend an awful lot of time in sleep paralysis, or you think anyone who does is doing it wrong. You've attempted to have an out-of-body experience, and you work at a call centre or some other job that requires ridiculous amounts of patience. If you guys want to add your own little roast or stereotype for a particular technique and the people who love it, write it down in the comments below. I'd love to hear some of yours. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe and enable all notifications so you can stay up to date when my new videos come out. And if you want to keep watching, check out one of the videos on screen. Go watch that, and I'll see you there soon. Take care and have some awesome lucid dreams.